These assholes, the fucking New York Jets, have fucking held up ESPN, a national TV network, now for 6 minutes.
Yeah. Maybe Tebow's having a fucking mental breakdown.
Fez, I notice you're not reading any of the other lines. Is there nobody getting off any good lines but you?
No, I've just been kind of concentrating on my own, and the other lines are flying by.
Good, honest answer. What are some of your jokes?
Mine was, this press conference is running really late, like the other jets flying into LaGuardia. And Tebow will be making sure the Jets now say grace before they have a snack.
I see movement. I knew they're coming out.
Yeah. Who's coming first?
He had a say in it. And here comes Tim Tebow as he makes his way across a large practice field to the podium.
Yeah, I was kind of looking forward to the contrast with Rex Ryan and Tim Tebow at the same podium. But as Chris mentioned, there's the owner's meeting going on. So I'm curious who's even going to introduce him, or he's just going to walk up on the stage like Bruce Springsteen and just start playing. We'll find out here in a second as he makes the walk.
I just want to point something out to you, my friend. Mel introduced Springsteen, so it happens.
Take the podium, take the microphone, and begin a news conference that apparently is going to start right now.
That's weird, right?
Yeah, you need someone to fucking... Rex should be there.
Now we can't even hear anybody.
How's it going? Good to see all of y'all. So, a lot of people here. No, it's such an honor for me to be here, and I'm so excited about being a Jet. Thank you all for coming. First and foremost, I just want to thank the Broncos for my time in Denver.
It was an amazing time.
I want to thank my teammates and the fans for being such great teammates and such great fans. And just that I'm looking forward to my time here in New York and my time as a Jet. And I'm so honored and humbled.
My short time as a Jet.
I'm so thankful that they wanted me. And I'm so excited about meeting my teammates. I've had the pleasure to meet quite a few already. And I'm looking forward to my future as a Jet. And I'm very, very excited about it. So with that, I would love to open it up for questions. Yes, ma'am.
Hi, welcome to New York.
Thank you.
I think there's a little bit of a discrepancy between what John Elway said in terms of you having control over where you go and then what you indicated on Wednesday night in the press conference call. And I just wanted to know kind of why that was or why you think that is and what the story is behind it.
Okay. Well, I guess a little bit of the story was when I woke up Wednesday morning, talked to Coach Fox, and they were very gracious the whole time. Coach Fox was...
He's like a nice woman. You know what I mean? Like, he's not... He talks like a nice woman.
Some of the opportunities that were out there. And then... and so I talked to him about it, and next thing I know, I got a call from Mr. Tannenbaum and Coach Ryan, and they said I was a Jet. So I was really excited about that. It was, something. So
he's just excited about everything.
I'm excited. When's the next flight out to New York? And I was excited about it. And
say excited and again before I go nuts.
Obviously, the media circus happened, and I found out a few minutes later that there was a snag in the contract, and I wasn't a Jet. And so then it was like 5 hours of kind of waiting, and Coach Fox was keeping me updated on what was happening. And then later on in the day, they said, well, we have a few teams that are interested, similar deals. And so he was very gracious to ask me, what I thought. And so I talked to him, very honestly about it. And I told him I would love to be a Jet. I told him that also the Jaguars are my hometown and, whatever was best for them. And he said the same for me. And ultimately, they had my contract and they had all the power, but he listened to me and what I had
to
say.
So he didn't choose.
And it was very gracious of them because they didn't have to do that.
What man says gracious?
They could have just
like six times already.
I know.
He listened
gracious
to me and
talked excited.
To me and I told him I would love to be a Jet. I love the coaches. I had an opportunity to be with Coach Sperano at the Senior Bowl. I had an opportunity to get to know Coach Ryan several times, and that was exciting for me. I also told him I would love to be a Jaguar. It was my hometown, and that would be exciting for me, and whatever was best for them. And so I'm excited to be a Jet, and I'm excited to be here.
Excited and gracious.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Everyone talks about how much of a competitor you are, and the Jets have said they're bringing you in to back up Mark Sanchez. So, as a competitor, do you want to be a starter? Do you hope to be the starter?
Well, I think for everybody that puts on a uniform, you want to go out there and you want to play. That's why you play the game of football, and I'm excited to be a Jet.
I'm excited, gracious.
To go out there and to help this team any way that I can. And whatever my role is, however I can expand that role, you know, I'm going to try to do
that. I wish I had a role right now. I'm starving.
Every day in practice, I'm going to go out there and compete and try to get better as a quarterback and try to figure out any ways possible to help this team any way that I can.
I'm going to help this team, and I'm excited and gracious.
How are you? Welcome to New York.
Thank you.
By all accounts, people say you're a very high character. And
some think you're gay.
It's not true.
It is true.
What is it like for you to hear speculation about how you could potentially, not maybe you personally, but you're coming to New York and, you know, maybe tension between you and Mark and the
spit it out, blockhead. What's your fucking question?
Stir up an
arm. Yeah, he's going to say something mean about Mark Sanchez.
Drop it in, Bob.
Think.
What is it like to hear about that sort of
thing? I'm not worried about Tex-Mex. I know I'll be able to whip his ass.
Me and Mark have a great relationship. We have had a good relationship for the last 3 years, I think. We've been friends.
Both wear half shirts.
We talked already.
We like mesh shorts.
You know, we have,
love GQ.
A relationship and a great working relationship, and I think we'll have a lot of fun together.
Yes, everybody has fun with a guy trying to beat him out for a job.
Have you spoken with Coach Ryan about where your role with the team is going to be in terms of number of carries? He said yesterday it could be up to 20 times we're going to see the Wildcat package.
Well, I have had time to spend with Coach Ryan. And
what's Sanchez going to do if there's 20 Wildcats?
How well it works, how it doesn't practice.
Hand off.
Yeah.
Obviously, you're not going to just put something out there if it's not executed and not running well. So I think it really matters, you know, how well we do and how well, you know, I can pick everything up and go out there and how well we're doing.
You've got to understand, I'm kind of stupid for a football player.
And try to execute as well as I possibly can and improve every single day.
Why don't you just play tight end like Gronk? You could be the Gronk right now, and everybody would love you.
Start partying, fucking.
No, not that. Oh. Just playing, you know, fucking strong, deep tight end. It's wide open in this league now.
Oh yeah, it's huge. The tight end's fucking blowing up.
Hey Tim, welcome.
Thank you.
I'm excited.
Report the other day that Mark was a little confused by the Jets going after you and making the trade. From your conversations with him, whether it be on the phone or text, did you get that impression that he is angry about this?
No, we're going to be having so much fun and excited.
Work together once
my new album's called Bad.
From my conversations with him, you know, he was excited, and he was excited about working with me.
I want a fucking excited head count.
About working with him. I have a lot of respect for him. You know, as a football player, as a person, he's always handled himself with so much class and integrity, and he's won a lot of games as a quarterback, and you know, I think we'll have a great working relationship. You know, we talked about that, and just supporting one another in our roles.
I'd like to get his money.
Yeah, I'm excited about that opportunity.
I'm excited.
I think we'll have a great relationship, and hopefully we'll be able to thrive together.
Separate excitement, relationship, and gracious.
Rex talked yesterday about maybe you doing, maybe playing other positions other than quarterback. I mean, it seems to me from what I've read about you, you know, you're pretty emphatic about quarterback being your position. Would you be open?
Rex talked about you wearing a giant football head and going to malls.
First and then quarterback. Although, you know, that is my dream. That's what I want to be, and it's what I believe I am as a quarterback.
The dream's over, idiot.
But you know, however I can help the team, however I can make a difference, however they can use me, I'll be open to it and work as hard as I can. Every time I step on that field, I would give my whole heart to being the best Jet that I can possibly be and trying to help
the best
team
Jet
win football games.
You're not actually going to fly.
Hi, Tim.
Hi.
You were talking about speaking to Coach Fox and saying that you would be thrilled to be a Jet. Just curious, what about the Jets was appealing to you to express that you would be interested in coming here, particularly since you're coming
really
out of a season in which you were a starter, and there's obviously a starter in place here, so...
I think, you know, first and foremost, it was my relationship with the coaches. It was having football coaches that believed in you, having football coaches that saw ability in me, and having coaches that I really respected for how they coached the game, for who they were, and my relationship. I've always had a great relationship with Coach Ryan, my relationship with Coach Bronco. I'm excited about working with Coach Kavanaugh. And then also you have so much support from Mr. Johnson, from Mr. Tannenbaum, and look at these facilities. They really don't get much better. And so, you know, there's a lot of pros here and not very many cons. I'm excited about that.
He's excited a lot.
First, what's your thoughts on this media crush here today, this whole process? And second of all, how do you make sure that this does not become a distraction when the season rolls on and this kind of attention is brought to you?
Well, it's, you know, it's an honor for all you to show up to hear me say a few words today. I really don't feel like it'll be too much a distraction because I honestly will try not to pay too much attention to it. And I mean, the reason we're doing this today is because I have bosses too, and they wanted me to stand up and talk to all y'all, so I can blame it on them because they made me do it, so.
Doesn't make sense.
Hey, Tim.
Hey.
Do you think
hey, fucker.
It's fair to put Mark in a position where you're the backup? You're obviously, if not the most popular player in the league, among the top, you know, handful. To have a,
no one's even close, buds.
With that type of popularity, perhaps having the fans clamor for you if he struggles. Is that fair to put him in that position?
Yes.
Yeah, I think Mark is very secure as a football player and as a person and who he is. And
no.
I think he's gonna,
it's the last thing he is secure. Fucking Fez was more secure this time 3 months ago.
Preparation and how he plays, and I think, you know, I'm excited about my role here too, and my,
I'm so excited.
My to compete,
Mark is going to teach me how to whistle out my asshole. So I'm excited about that.
And be stronger together than we would be apart.
Mark, what do you think your Tebow? What do you think your head weighs? It looks like a fucking refrigerator.
Well, I'm sad to say that's about 15 pounds.
How many hams can you keep in your giant mouth?
Of your game has been
three, four?
Well, I think that I'm improving every single day. I've been working very hard, and
yeah, you're always improving when there's not a game on.
Coach Mazzoni, who is a former Jet coach, and
you're big fucking
extremely hard to improve in every area of
the
game.
Tim, how do you feel when the Jets' biggest player of all time, Joe Namath, threw up in his own mouth?
Understanding defenses, understanding the schemes, how we go about it, how we take advantage of defenses, reads, reactions, fundamentals, all those things. And, you know, I'm excited about the opportunity.
He's excited this kid.
Tim, you mentioned that you know Mark for 3 years. I'm wondering where that relationship stems from.
And how do you make yourself come? Since you are a virgin.
The first time we met, I think it might have been at the ESPYs one year, a few years ago. And then we've just...
We held hands at the ESPYs.
We had to do one appearance at a Super Bowl a few years ago together where we were throwing to fans and other people. And so we had a good time with that. We had to do a question and answer.
Ryan in the Bronx.
At one of those Super Bowl appearances.
Hi, Ron. Hi, Pepper. Hi, Fez. I have a nickname for Tim Tebow. It is called the run-on sentence because he's overexcited. He doesn't put periods in his sentence, and he's very excited to be here, very gracious. He has to work on his media skills, and I think if he put a period...
He's gigantic. He's gigantic in media.
Hi, Tim. How much pressure are you feeling from all of this, not the media?
You've got to understand pressure before you feel it, honey. He doesn't give a fuck.
Rex Ryan is saying...
Everything's good to him.
On the internet and out in the media. How much pressure are you feeling at this point?
None, actually. I don't really feel too much pressure.
Zero. He just thinks about eternity with God.
You know, how exciting it is. I'm excited to be a Jet. And,
excited.
You know, I got a long way to go before OTAs or training camp, so I'm just continuing.
How about OTB?
It's gone.
Just continue to try to improve.
Very excited to get rid of OTBs.
No!
Getting up to it, but... you know, I've always enjoyed pressure, and I've always, been, you know, before every time I get up and give a speech, before every practice, before every football game I play, I always get a little bit nervous, and that's something that excites me. I think that's something that I play better.
I feel it, my balls.
I have more on the line, and that's something that I've always tried to thrive on, and when that feeling goes away, that'll probably be the time when I stop playing football. So, I'm excited about, you know, just the support that we have as a Jet, the fans, you know, how passionate they are. I've been very blessed in my past to have passionate fans. When I was at the University of Florida, you know, Gator Nation is very powerful and it's everywhere. So that was a lot of fun. And then, you know, being a Bronco, they have extremely passionate fans, which I was, you know, very blessed to have support me, and now being a
I count the blessed as part of the God stuff.
You have so many fans that support us as Jets, and they're so passionate. And you know, I realized that when we played the Jets last year, and we were playing them at our home field, and they had a lot of fans there, and they were cheering pretty loud, and that was exciting to see. And
you're always happy, no matter what happens.
Extremely looking forward to our first game to see what the atmosphere is really like.
Tim, does anything ever annoy you?
Excuse me, what has Coach Ryan told you about how he's going to use you, and what was your relationship with him until a few days ago?
We were boyfriend and girlfriend.
My relationship with him has always been great, and we've continued to build a relationship throughout the last few years, and just in our conversations.
What do you mean, the woman said to him?
And Jimmy Sexton. And
what are you talking about now?
I'm trying to remember the first place we met. I think it might have been at a pro day or something like that where we met. But then I know we spent some time together at the Super Bowl this year. And we got to have a great conversation there. And, you know, I've always watched him. I got to see Hard Knocks and see how he coached, and that was fun. And, you know, from our conversations that we've had the last few days, you know, I think he's just excited that I'm here. And I think, you know, it's a day-by-day process to see, you know, what happens and how well, you know, whatever the Wildcat is working. And, well, I think it's a day-by-day process and, you know, figuring out what works and how I can fit into this team and try to make this team a little bit better. And that's my goal is, you know, by being on this team, you know, I'll be a great teammate, hopefully a good asset and someone that can help us try to win a few football games.
Take two more from local and then open up everyone.
Tim, there's a feeling that defenses in the NFL have caught up to the Wildcat a little bit. As someone that's going to be a big part of it here, do you still feel that it can be a viable option, particularly with how much the Jets anticipate using you?
Well, yeah, I think one misconception is people think that the Wildcat is just a direct snap to a running
Wildcat.
Back and you fake it and you run power or outside zone or inside zone. And I think that's a big misconception because I think when you have the ability to have 11 people touch the ball on, or not 11 people.
That doesn't make sense. You
know, 5-6 people that have the opportunity to touch the ball on every
single
like,
play. The tackle is going to run for a lot of fucking touchdowns.
I think it can be confusing. I think it can make defenses play slow. And I think when you have a great offensive coordinator like Coach Barano that can put together packages and plays and not necessarily.
Why hasn't anyone done the what does come taste like fucking question to him yet?
Tim, the Jets have been accused of or criticized for making this trade for non-football reasons. Even Joe Namath went on the radio and called it a publicity stunt. I'm wondering, do you take offense to that or do you find it insulting?
No, I love it.
As it relates to your abilities as a football player?
I really don't take offense to that. And, you know, I don't think it's true because, you know, I think the Jets get a lot of support as it is and they have a lot of great fans. And so I don't think it has much to do with that. I think it has more to do with just some coaches believing in me and hopefully, you know, thinking that I'm an okay football player. And I'm just excited that I have the opportunity to be a Jet and hopefully I can add something to this great franchise and organization.
Hey, so much has been said about you and your faith and all the attention that you receive.
Finally.
Some have been saying that the reason why you receive so much attention like today is because of your faith. If that, in fact, is the case, how do you feel about that? Are you okay with that?
I don't like God anymore.
You know, obviously, I'm someone that's very outspoken about my faith, and, you know, I've never been ashamed of it, and I always, anytime I get the opportunity, I always thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, because that is the most important thing to me. But I don't think all the attention is just because of my faith. I think sometimes it adds a little bit to it. I'm pretty sure I'm not the first athlete that has gotten on a knee and prayed, but somehow it's known as Tebowing, and I'm not sure why. And
he loved it, retweeted it.
I don't know, probably had to do a little bit with the hype, but you know, I think it's not all a bad thing. If people are still somehow talking about prayer or talking about my faith, then I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah, real cool.
And talking with Mark Sanchez.
You wouldn't know cool if it was hanging off your balls, kid. You're the exact opposite of cool.
He did say, get ready for y'all. No, he just, you know, it's just fun. He got a great relationship, and he just said, we're going to have a lot of fun together. It'll be fun working
together. I'm loving it. I'm excited to find out where the Cracker Barrels are.
I'm watching film in the QB room that I think it's so important to have.
I know they got turkey sausage there now, and I'm excited.
You know, you can get along with, that you can joke around with, that you can make fun of, and have a great time. And so I think just as far as that goes, we'll have a great relationship. And then also, you know, have McElroy in there as well, Alabama guy, so that'll be tough.
Oh, boy. I'm still holding on to college.
It's
Tim, you're known for your charity work. You have your own foundation. You just came this weekend from an event in Alabama. Are you planning to establish a foundation or a group here in New Jersey? In Denver, you did it, and you have a couple of other organizations outside the country. But are you looking to do it here in New Jersey? Have you thought about it? What did the team think about that?
Well, absolutely. I'm looking forward to doing things here
I've given up charity.
Figuring out a way to just try to make a difference and try to help. And you know, my foundation is something that is extremely important to me, and it's something that I'm very proud of. And I'm so proud of the 650 orphans that we support, or the 18 Timmy's Playrooms that we're building, or the hospital in the Philippines that we're building, because ultimately I know that that's more important than anything I do on a football field, is the ability to brighten a kid's day, or the ability to make someone smile, or the ability, because you know we're put on a pedestal as a football player, which makes us no more important or no more special than anybody else. But you have an opportunity, and I believe more than that, it's a responsibility to be a good role model, to set a good example, and to make a difference in kids' lives, especially the kids that are looking up to you because you play football. And
what a sweet kid.
I remember when I was 8 years old and Danny Werfel came to my church as a Florida Gators quarterback, and I waited.
How was his pro career?
I was probably the 120th kid in line, and I waited an hour, but he signed all the autographs and waited till I got to him, and I still remember how that made me feel as a little boy, and I still have that autograph in my parents' house in Jacksonville, Florida, because I remember how it made me feel. And so, you know,
it's not worth 3 cents.
So busy and so caught up in the hustle and bustle, and forget about being a role model, forget about setting a good example and making a difference in people's lives that are looking.
We don't doubt you'd wait all night for a little boy to come in and sit on your lap.
Being here and being a football player is to set a great example, and I'm excited about this opportunity.
Stop saying excited, kid. You're
Tim, a lot of athletes can't handle New York. What equips you to deal with the demands, the challenges, and the circus that may come to town?
Yeah, I feel like
trapeze.
At University of Florida, you have a pretty big platform there, and then just
let's bring it down for a second.
For 2 years in the NFL.
Let's go over here to David. David, how do you think Tebow's doing?
Hey, what's going on, Ronnie B?
Hey,
he's superhuman, right? He's taken one breath at the beginning of the press conference, and I don't think he's breathed since, Rob.
It's really true, and he's just out there. He's just like full heart, you know, with these people. He's just busting his butt to just say the right thing. Everything that happens is wonderful to him. There's no bad things at all.
There's like no cynicism whatsoever. It's
really
weird.
Hey, Rick, you're on
my defense. Yeah, I just wonder why you're blowing this guy so much shit, man. He just wanted to be there, you know.
Who gives a? Now you sound as dull as him. No, the thing is, I'm loving this because everybody in New York is freaking out over it, and literally the kid has nothing to say. He's in his early to mid 20s. He hasn't done a real lot. He could not be sweeter or a kinder kid. This is all about his personality, and it's all about his faith. And very little about his ability to play football. Let's face something here. He got traded for a fucking fourth round draft pick. It's not exactly a franchise player.
He's going to fucking destroy shit with that wildcat, though. I mean, it's going to go non.
I'm a believer until September, and then I'll turn on him. I just want it to happen over and over for him then.
Fuck shit up.
Here's Ezra, you're on manifest.
Hey, who knew Tebow was a pointer sister? He's so excited, and he just can't hide it. He's about to lose control, and I think he likes it.
You and Davey Mac were rough on him the other night, Hicks.
Yeah, we were fucking shitting a little bit on Tebow. It's okay, though. I mean, no, it's just the fact that, not Tebow, but the Jets, that to fucking sign him, and that they don't want to win Super. They don't want to win games, and that fucking being in the media is more important to them. Like, I'm sure they are all fucking loving it that everyone's talking about this press conference, and that it's all over the fucking place.
Yeah,
and it's fucking exciting. I like fucking watching it. But as a football organization, it's kind of fucking crazy.
Yeah, but they're not selling out any of their fucking these booths and shit that they have. They got to make a little money for themselves. Yeah. Woody Johnson's going broke.
I don't know if he's going broke.
It ain't Johnson and nothing. It's Johnson and Johnson.
You can sell some fucking baby powder.
Here is here's Cam Albany, Yarmouth Fest.
Hey, yo, Ronnie, what up?
says that Tebow hasn't done anything yet. He says he's still a young kid. But, I mean, he's got a Heisman, right? He's got a national.
No, he doesn't have a Heisman. He won the Heisman his junior year?
Yeah, junior year.
Not his senior. Yeah, he didn't win the senior Heisman. And that doesn't mean shit. It doesn't mean nothing. You're in the fucking pros now. He just got traded for a fourth round fucking pick. If he's a franchise player, there's no way Denver fucking lets go of him. The greatest, or at least one of the greatest, but you can honestly argue that the greatest quarterback of his generation was Elway. You could actually argue that the greatest of all time is Elway. And he picked a fucking 36-year-old man
with no neck,
with a damaged neck, over this kid.
Oh, yeah, and loved it. Had no fucking problem. This is what he fucking wanted. He went full fucking force into this thing.
Let's go over Liam. Liam, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Yeah, I just want to know when Tebow gets lonely if he plays with his St. Peter.
Oh, stop that. Todd, you're on Run and Fez.
Yeah, who's going to get outed first, Tebow or Rick Santorum?
I don't know if he's gay, but he's certainly very effeminate.
Yeah.
He
passed up on Kim Kardashian. She wanted a piece of that Tebow.
Yeah, for that I don't respect him. Ray, you're on Run Fez.
Yeah, you know, you always see Tebow's mom on TV and stuff. We never knew who his father was. I think it's Mr. Rogers.
I don't know. He was brought up to be very polite, very Christian. Shower Bench writes, I admire people like him because he's white and conservative and Christian. Well, I can understand that, you know?
Yeah.
That is nice things, to be white, conservative, and Christian. I mean, we're not even going to have that as our next president. We will not get a white. Only one of them comes across conservative. No, sorry, they're both moderates. Christian. Only one of them is a Christian, the other. Mormon. So between the two of them, I guess they could make it.
Some weird fucking dual presidency.
Let's go over to Jack. Jack, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Wildcat.
Wildcat. Wildcat.
Wildcat. That was smooth Tenenbaums rounding
piece. Thanks, man. John, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, excited, now known as the E-word.
It is kind of the E-word. Johnny, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Yeah, what's up, boys? Yeah, this circus called the Jets. I know there's meetings going on now. How do you have no owner, no GM, and no head coach there? And not even maybe a star player. I've never seen this before at a press conference.
Yeah, it's no one is supporting him. No one wants to be seen next to him. I've never seen a press conference where no one from the team walked out and said, folks, here is our next...
You know, never. Listen, if the Yankees bat boy retires, the owner's there, the GM is there.
Yeah.
The Jets have no one. I just can't. It's a circus, guys.
I think they don't want to be sucked down with them if this doesn't work.
Yeah.
I would have fucking thought if Ryan would have been there for fucking sure.
Because the thing is, you normally, if you're going to do a press conference, say, ladies and gentlemen, we want to bring out the next quarterback for the New York Jets, but he's not.
He's the next backup quarterback.
He is not. It's fucking crazy town.
And their other backup who signed, got like a $500,000 signing bonus, was like, as soon as the Tebow thing, he's already gone.
Get a hold of Hard Rock Johnny for me. Get a hold of the big Giants fan, because he's got to be loving this. Now, someone wrote in that Tebow was good-looking. I think he looks like a fucking Frankenstein to me.
He looks somewhat like Gronk.
Yeah, he really is Gronky-looking. That's also why I'd like to see him play tight end.